This life, I can't keep myself. I can't keep myself. Allow me to flex. This life, I can't keep myself. I can't keep myself.
Welcome back to my channel. You're welcome to my YouTube channel. Happy new month, happy December. Please don't forget to enjoy yourself this December. Please, it's been a really long year, so please do well to enjoy yourself, take good care of yourself, go on a very nice treat. So on today's episode, you know, I'm going to be talking about something that is quite underrated. You know, mental health in Nigerian universities is quite underrated, and it's something we really need to look into and be intentional about. So I'll be taking us through how I was able to manage stress throughout pharmacist school. Even if you are not a pharmacy student, you're doing another course, you can also pick one or two things that to learn to manage stress. Even if you're a working class, you can pick one or two things to manage stress. So let's dive right in what we have today. I don't know why I'm a single, which I don't understand. Like, it's just shocking me to think. This December is doing me so much. Oh my God. Okay, so there are several ways in which I was able to manage stress, and I'll be sharing with us some of the ways in which I was able to manage stress. Number one, prioritize your task. Prioritizing your task helps you to take it one step at a time, and you are able to achieve something when you take it one step at a time. You know, sometimes when you have, you know, when you have all the things you have to do in your head, oh, I have to do this, I have to do that, I have to do that, and everything is just like running through your head. If you write them down in order of priority in which they ought to be achieved, and you're doing it one by one, you realize that all the things are actually running through your head. They are not more than this thing, and you'll be like, ah, so it's not even more than this thing, I can't do it now. And you do it one by one. If I not finish it that day, you move it to the next day. Or if you have to give it to someone else, you give it to someone else. You understand? Take one step at a time. Don't do copy. Don't run your life by another person's clock. Even if you guys are four friends, very close, best friend, everything, four of you cannot do everything the same way. Okay, take for instance, you know, some people, they read and assimilate well in the library. Some people read and assimilate well in their rooms. Some read and assimilate well with group discussions, group reading, and all of that. Personally, me, I'm not a library person. Me, I'm not a going to class overnight and all those kind of things. I read in my room, on my bed. The day I tried to do this copy thing, so I went to there's this class, we always do this overnight reading, and also people call from different places to read. So I shall went there, I shall went to read that. Okay, let me just read something as for everybody's doing overnight and all. And I went to read, though. My brothers and sisters, I slept when it was like almost 12 o'clock. I just told myself, see, liar, rather than sleeping on this wooden chair and suffer myself, I am going to walk back to my room, sleep on my bed, and know that I'm going to have a good night's sleep, rather than sleeping on this bench and coming back in the morning and everybody hailing me, Jagaban, hey, Jaco, please don't hail me, I'm not cooking with anything, so let me just go and sleep. So yes, don't copy, know what works for you. It's very important for you to know what works for you and live by it. Keep a positive attitude. I know that the stress and the tension is always on the high side during examination, you know, as in like exam. Hey, I have a lot of things to cover. I've not covered this. I've not covered that. I have to do this. I have to do that. And you know, a lot of things are running through your head to do during exam period. See, let me tell you something. If you know that after you write a paper and everybody's saying, what did you write here? If you know it will make you depressed, or it will give you high blood pressure, my brethren, there's no need for you to compare your answers after the examination. You can just go out and pray to God to bless what you have. Another important point is to recognize and identify your strengths and weaknesses. You cannot do everything. Know your limits. Know when to say no, know when to say yes. Know when to call for help. See, it's not every time that you should be doing Jagabano. It's not every time that you should be doing ad guy, ad girl. See, even ad guy, ad girl, so they get their limits. So know your limits. And there's this thing of, I'm going to take coffee every day to stay awake. because I want to read, or because I want to, yeah, basically read, or because I want to do one thing, I want to cover this thing by force, by fire. Avoid taking too much of coffee or caffeine products, because very high doses of these things can lead to side effects that might disrupt a person's day-to-day activities and might even lead to serious mental health issues. Mental health is real low, so please avoid taking too much. Take it in
moderation.
Would always need help at any point in time, so connect with people that would render help
with
the gift of men, so make good use of it.
One very important thing that we need to understand when it comes to managing stress is that, one,
always remember that you are human and you cannot get everything right at once, so learn to take a
finally
break.
Oh, please
take out time to enjoy yourself, take out time to sleep, take out time,
because
you know you can't just graduate and all the things you remember when you graduate is just the lamenting, is the hard times, the exams and all of that. Please remember, have a good memory of good things, have a good memory of the other things you ventured into, have a good memory of the times you enjoyed with friends, have a good memory of the gifts of men that you enjoyed in school, have a good memory of the skills that you
learned
in which you can manage stress. And it's not limited to what I've said earlier, but I know that what I've said earlier are like the major point that you can play
around.
Along the line also, you would
what
learn. Suits best for you in managing stress. Thank you for coming to my TED Talk. If you have not subscribed to my channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button, hit the like button.
This life I can't keep myself. I can't keep myself. I can't keep myself. Allow me to flex. This life I can't keep myself.